Well, greetings, everyone. It is Saturday, August 1. It's already August. And I know that sounds maybe a little bit strange, like already August, because for a lot of us, it seems like for the last few months, time has stood still. And maybe a lot of us have felt like we've been in a little bit of a time warp. And then there are those of us who feel that, man, time is just moving so quickly. Hey, just want to give you hopefully an encouraging word for today. I was just reading in some of the Psalms, and particularly a section of the Psalms that are really considered maybe Psalms of deliverance. The middle section of the Psalms, particularly in the 40s, the 40-something Psalms. Particularly one, Psalm 42, maybe Psalm 42 is very familiar to many of you, where it talks about the soul, the psalmist's soul longing for God, like and thirsting for God, like the deer pants and thirst for water. And then there's that section where those who are unbelieving and those who are cynical and skeptical are asking of the psalmist, where's God in this time, this difficult time, this hard time that obviously the psalmist is living through? And there's that point when, again, you hear the agony. You do. You hear the anguish of his own soul as he looks out around him and just ponders again how difficult things are. And when it gets to the end of that psalm, it's almost like he is speaking truth, but the truth that he's speaking is that it's almost like you can almost hear him rehearsing it out loud to himself, where, for instance, as he closes out the psalm, why are you in despair, O my soul? And why have you become disturbed within me? Hope in God. Hope in God. For I shall yet praise him, the help of my countenance and my God. So there is that point where you almost can imagine that the encouragement that he's speaking, the affirmation, the truth that he's speaking, he is speaking out loud to himself, because that's exactly what he needs. And I could be speaking today, most likely I am, to someone who just needs to be reminded of that. Probably most of us. I know I do. I need to be reminded of that. That again, our help comes from the Lord. And by the way, in that same section of the Psalms, Psalm 46 begins like this: God is our strength and our refuge, a very present help in time of trouble. And then listen to this, what follows verse 1 of Psalm 46. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth should change. Listen, in the last 6 months, it does absolutely feel like the world around us has changed. Hope in God. Don't fear. Because though there are a lot of things that have changed and will continue to change around us, there is one constant, there is one consistent, there is one anchor of the soul, and he's Jesus. And so may you be encouraged today. I hope that is a little bit of encouragement for you. A couple of things I want to remind you of as we come in, particularly to the RMCC Faith family, as we come into this weekend. This Sunday, tomorrow, we will be singularly focused on communion and the experience of communion. We'll have some of these pre-packaged, hopefully you can see that. Yeah, some of these pre-packaged communion elements, just so that you're a little bit familiar with it. And I know you're incredibly smart people, but sometimes it's a little bit tricky. There's a little cellophane tab that is attached to the larger tab. This cellophane tab comes off independently so that you can have the wafer. It pulls off the top out of that little cellophane, and then you can pull the big tab, the larger tab, for the juice. I hope that makes sense. Again, these are prepackaged elements. They are, again, for this time and for this season, for, again, we're just trying to be responsible and safe. So they'll be available for you. You'll be able to walk up to a table, grab one. Again, the tab is a little cellophane part. Pull off, pull the wafer off, and then take the larger tab for the juice. For those who will be sharing tomorrow's service online, that will be the time when we have our walk-up communion. For those who are here, that will be the time to make sure that your elements are prepared and you'll be able to partake in the Lord's Supper with us. All right. Just a couple of other reminders. Our next session of emotionally healthy spirituality will begin this month in just a few weeks. Go to the website rmchurch.org. It'll tell you everything about the course, and it'll tell you how to get signed up. And if you have not participated in one of our past sessions of emotionally healthy spirituality, I really want to encourage you to do that. I really do believe that everyone in our church should go through both of those courses, emotionally healthy spirituality and emotionally healthy relationships. They're just so core. They're so fundamental to everything we understand about following Jesus and being healthy, truly spiritually healthy, emotionally healthy disciples. So go to the website. It'll tell you all about that. There are other opportunities that are coming up. One opportunity I want to also remind you of is that beginning this week, we'll be making available tours of our new building. We'll be doing that, I think, in smaller groups of about six. You'll need to have your own personal mask. We'll be, again, observing all the COVID protocols and so forth just to keep people safe. But it's a great, great time and an opportunity for you to come through and look at how God has blessed us. And look at the fruit of your generosity and your giving and your faithfulness. So again, go to the website, rmchurch.org, or call the church office. Call the church office. We'll get you set up for one of those. And just let us know how we can serve you in that way. All right? Hey, God bless you. I look forward to seeing many of you tomorrow, if not here, certainly online. All right.